In this topic, we're going to be talking about dev test labs within Azure. And basically what that allows you to do, when you create these dev test environments, you can kind of schedule around when you need your environment to be up. So you can schedule around when your developers are going to be working. So maybe like a 9 to 6, a typical work day, they go home, and then you can kind of spin down your environment or deallocate everything. And what this allows you to do is kind of control the cost, so your Azure resource costs don't go out of control while you're doing these while you're doing development or tests. And then you can schedule all these resources to be spun back up in the morning and be ready for the developers to come back in and get back at it. And there's also a couple of other extensions. You can extend this with other sources like a GitHub repository or different things like that. And so Cal is going to actually take us through a demo of Dev Test Labs.
Yeah, I think it's important to understand like the use case here. Really what this is after is kind of what Ed was saying, right? So like we have typically in enterprises where people are doing development, we have an environment where they're actually doing integrated testing. Typically, the developer works on his workstation to do local development, which then gets pushed to an integrated dev environment. The integrated dev environment probably has some test data that we need to use when we're testing out our product to make sure that it handles all the use cases correctly and we have good code coverage, those kind of things. So in that model, basically the things that we show with dev test, or dev test labs we call it right now, is really around how do we build an environment and encapsulate it such that we can kind of automate, like Ed said, the startup and shutdown, but also like what images, like base images we're going to use inside of there. So we have operating systems involved with these machines that we're going to use in the lab. And those images can come from, like he said, a GitHub repo, like our quick start templates, or some of the actual marketplace images. So the stuff that's actually deployed out there that you can consume and put inside of your Azure account, you could also put it in Dev Test Labs. And so it's an easy way to kind of get started with that. I'll walk through a little bit of it here. When you come in here, it's under Dev Test Labs. If you don't have it showing up on your list, you can add that. It's in preview now, and I have one spun up here so we can see what it actually looks like. Now, I don't have any VMs in here, but here's where your actual VMs would come up, and you could basically set policies around when they should start and when they should shut down, as well as what base image they should use. Here's where you could manage all your virtual machines, so you would see everything listed. This just shows your top ones here. And under the artifact repo is where you could actually point to other things that you want to involve in your dev test environment. So here's where, as Ed was saying, you could point out to a GitHub, right? So you could point out to either VSO that we have highlighted here in the portal. So we have, you can provision Git inside of, it's actually called VSTS at this point, but VSO is what the old name used to be. And basically you can have artifacts out there or pieces that are needed for your environment to work. And so you can kind of link out to those and add more artifacts into your dev environment. And what's interesting is as you bring those pieces into the dev environment, they're shared by all the developers, so they're doing their job. But then at nighttime, all the virtual machines and things that are costing lots of money are actually can be powered down automatically. Now, I was talking with Ed, you know, these kind of things can be scripted, right? So you could create a nice script to kind of do all this stuff. But if anybody's been through that process, it's not easy. You know, it sounds easy when you have one or two machines. But as soon as developers are involved in a big enterprise, you have hundreds of machines. And now you got to figure out like how you're going to orchestrate this and make sure that you shut things down the right way and which ones need to be scheduled. Pretty soon you're writing schedulers and all kinds of things to do this. And this is kind of a nice like area for you to kind of build those kind of environments around so that you can manage them better and keep your costs under control as you're doing development.
And so, Kyle, I had a question about this. So do dev test labs, do they only really manage VMs in your environment, or are there other services within Azure that they manage?
You can pull other assets in, but it doesn't do like websites or any of that kind of stuff right now. Yeah, it's primarily focused around virtual machines, so less of the PaaS model and more of that. It also does things like, I mean, if you look in here, and I don't have anything deployed, but what's interesting is they have these nice little UIs that are built in here to allow you to basically manage costs. So you can get your insights and thresholds, and you can set all kinds of nice little alerts and things in here directly in the portal and kind of visualize it. Again, you can get some of this stuff from the API. In fact, you can get almost all of this from the API, but it would be hard, right? You have to write a lot of scripts and do a lot of things around that. And here's where you can actually set up how many VMs per user. So there's all kinds of nice little settings in here for particularly around IaaS. You can see everything's around VMs, but around how many VMs we're allowed to run in this environment. So you can kind of, you know, control your costs there, as well as kind of look at your telemetry about the system.
Right, so it just gives you an easy kind of wrapper around your whole environment where you can see it kind of from one pane of glass and kind of manage it instead of writing those scripts and going through all that painstaking work just to do this, which where it's easily manageable right here.
Exactly. And so that wraps the module on Dev Test Labs in Azure.